really good friends, and I think it's great that that chemistry comes through on camera.
So the season finale showed a little Easter egg of you as the actual Frost.
Yes. Yeah, that's what I like to repeat that.
All right, so where will season two pick up on that tease at all?
I hope so. I would love to see that. I mean, the movies is the best one on the show. I know about Hill Frost, and I'm wildly excited to play her. I would like for it to happen in season two. I don't know that it will happen in season two. Stay tuned.
What was it like getting to dress up at least?
Oh my gosh, it was so cool. I loved it. We started working on that whole look many months prior. And then it was incredible to see it, you know, all come together, all the different pieces, you know, because we work on them independently. The first wig I tried on was a pixie wig, and then we started adding layers and that sort of thing, and the look of the makeup evolved, and then finally, you know, putting the suit, the wig, the makeup, and the contacts, like, it's transformative. It's awesome.
So CW has a Killer Frost suit for you waiting in the wings should something happen.
Yeah. Yeah. I wish they'd run it down here. That would have been cool. I'm like desperate to be one of the guys where you're like out there duking
it out. Yeah, that's a good idea.
I wish they
had. So we've heard that with the multiverses being a possibility for season two, that there could be an alternate timeline being explored week to week. Are you ready to explore the multiversions of what could Caitlin's life could be like?
Yes. Yeah, I mean, it's a really interesting concept. It also produces a challenge as an actor. You know, I remember when we did just, I think it was episodes 15 and 16, you know, asking the question, so if Caitlin's living this day over again, does she wake up and choose to put the same clothes on? Like, it's Tuesday, so does she wear the same skirt and top? Or, you know, Tuesday, Monday was different, so now she wears a different outfit. Things like that. You know, you get to, you start there, and that's a small thing. You know, and just see how it changes.
So now that Ronnie and Caitlin are married, are we going to see more of Ronnie on the show at all?
I hope so. I love Ronnie. I would love to see
him. But nothing is confirmed. Do you have any films with Robbie
yet? That was me dodging the question!
That was me following up.
Her Caitlin's story
lab. I'd like to see her out of Star Labs a little bit more. You know, the karaoke episode is one of my favorites, and I don't necessarily think we need to repeat that. But it would be great to see her outside.
So,
how do you think the kind of the compliment? How do you think we will become Killer Frost? And how will you become?
How will you
Frost
become? How you transform into this? I don't know that. I mean, what's great? One of the things I love about the show is how much faith I have in our writers, and they give us excellent material all the time. And so, when it comes time to make that transformation, I trust them, and I know that they will do it well.
But speaking of that faith, what is kind of like the most surprising thing you came across in the first season? What's the most ridiculous idea? Gorilla?
Everything was the same. Gorilla, Reverse Flash, time travel. Like, we didn't do it all, but we did a lot for one season of television. So, it's true. Every time I read the script, I'm like, oh, we're doing that. All right. You know, it's great. It's fun.
All right. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Bye, guys.